This is the plaintiff, Jira Green. She says she paid the defendant, a so-called electrician, to install a new electrical panel in her house, and he almost caused an explosion. That's right, her house could have blown up because he didn't upgrade things properly. And she wants him to refund the $1,300 she's owed. This is the defendant, Dennis Harris. He says he's a qualified electrician who's been doing this kind of work since he was 9 years old back in Jamaica. He did an excellent job for the plaintiff. She's just mad because he told her he was going to charge her for some additional work, which she wanted him to do for free. And here they are. He's accused of charging up a customer.
All parties, please raise your right hands. People's Court is now in session. The Honorable Judge Marilyn Millian is now presiding. Litigants have been sworn, Your Honor.
Thank you, Douglas.
You're welcome.
All right, Ms. Green, you are suing your former electrician, Mr. Harris, for $1,300 that you paid him that you want returned to you because what he did almost blew up your house. Tell me what happened.
I met the defendant in Queens on Farmers one day, and I just bought this house in Long Island. And I was explaining to him I needed an electrician for my pool, to upgrade my electrical work in my house, to get a pool and a spa. So I gave him the opportunity to come to my house.
The words you said to him were what? I need somebody to upgrade my panel?
My panel is 100 watts, and I need it to be 200 to hold the pool and the spa. That's what I asked him. So he said he'll upgrade the panel. Come to find out, when on April 5th, he came, I gave him $500. He changed couple of circuit breakers. Then he came back again on May 14, 2020. I gave him $1,000. He's supposed to finish the work. He never finished. A couple of weeks later, one of the circuit breakers blew. The power went up outside, upstairs. The TV went out, and my room went out. And so I called Dennis, and I said, my TV's going out in my room. Something's wrong. So when I went downstairs, and I looked, but I didn't. I just clicked the circuit breaker, went back. So I clicked it back, and then I called him. He kept saying he was at work. He never came. That's when I hired another electrician, and I kept calling Dennis. He would never come.
Okay. And then you have the estimate from the new electrician who's saying this panel needs to be upgraded. Did you actually pay them, and did they already upgrade it?
Yeah, it's already done.
Okay.
I paid them already.
All right. And Mr. Harris, what's your response to what she's saying? She's saying that what you did was useless because she needed to upgrade the panel. Talk to me.
Okay, Your Honor. She said she needs me to come and look at her panel at her house because when she turned her air conditions on, it trips. I went over to her house. She had a 16-circuit panel, which is a small panel, and half of the wires were not in it because she said there was no outlets, right? So I did the panel. Miss Green paid me.
What do you mean by did the panel? I'm going to need you to be more specific. What does panel mean?
I install a new panel, a 36-way circuit panel in Miss Green's basement.
Okay. Did you increase the amperage from 100 to 200?
That was after I finished. When I finished and got paid, she called me and bugged me about it. I said, you have to give me $250 extra.
She said, okay. Had she ever said to you that she wanted you to increase the amperage?
After I finished the job.
No, but I mean before, had she ever said it?
No.
So why do you think she was saying it now? Because she says that whatever you put in wasn't going to be able to support the pool and everything else. Because things
Your
were
Honor.
Tripping. First she said you were blowing up her house, but now she says it's just click, click, click because it was turning off, which was the same problem she had before, though, wasn't it?
Yes, and I changed and put in a brand new circuit panel.
Okay.
All brand new breakers.
Okay, I hear you, but Mr. Harris, hear me. She had a problem, and that is that her TV went out, and this went out, and that went out, so something was seriously wrong. So when she calls you, what do you tell her? Well, let me go look at it and see what's wrong, or you just tell her, pay me more money?
No, I didn't tell her. I said to her, I'm coming there. I come to see what is the problem. I went, I checked it. I said, I don't see any problem. How you say a TV blue? I stood there with her for a couple. I said, turn everything on. Turn everything on while I'm here. And let me see if there's anything blue. And nothing blue, Your Honor.
Okay. And so, but you know it happened because she called you and told you it happened. She's not going to make it up out of whole cloth. If it wasn't happening, there's no reason to call you. She already paid you. You already left. She's not making it up. So maybe it just didn't happen the time that you were standing there. You know, if it happens at all, it's a problem.
But Your Honor, what I'm saying, yeah, it's a problem. But what I'm saying, Your Honor, if I tell her to turn everything on while I'm there, if there was any problem, it would have tripped if it was rigged.
Mr. Harris, do you think she was lying about it tripping and that's why she called you?
That's what she's doing, Your Honor.
Oh, you think the breakers never tripped when she called you and said, the breakers tripped, that you think she made that up?
Yeah, she made it up because she wanted to dust because I said, give me money to do the panel, extra money. She says, no.
Okay,
I paid you already.
But Mr. Harris, hear me out a second. Something caused her to call you, right?
The circuit breaker.
Ms. Green, I'm not talking to you. Mr. Harris, something caused Ms. Green to call you.
Maybe, Your Honor, sometimes maybe it could be an extra voltage coming in or something like that and tripped.
Okay, so what ended up, let me see. Now, how is it that are you a licensed electrician, Mr. Harris?
Not yet.
I didn't know.
All right. What do you mean you didn't know?
He told me he did have one.
He told you he was licensed? Why didn't you ask to see it?
He said he was licensed.
Why don't you ask to see it? Nobody cares. Everybody just wants a good price. And then after everything hits the fan, of a sudden, they're Ms. Show me your license. Okay.
I didn't ask.
All right. So now here is the new proposal. How is it that they wanted to charge, $2,500?
He charged more. I got more work done.
So how am 8, I going to, right, so how am I going to figure out what it costs to upgrade it? You want all the money back, but he brought wires in there and he did work. So you'll have to explain to me how all of the work was useless. That's what I need to understand.
Okay, because he only did the panel, Judge Melinda. He did the panel. That was it. He didn't do anything but the panel.
Yeah, I know.
And I had to get a whole new panel. Right, the panel, I paid $1,500.
According to him, the upgrade part would have been $250. How would the upgrade part have only been $250, Mr. Harris?
It was
Mr. Harris. How was the upgrade part going to only be $250? Explain to me what $1,500 covered and what $250 would have covered.
Okay. $1,500 was for the panel to install a new circuit panel, 36 circuit panels, 36 breakers, a brand new panel. I put the panel, take the old one off the wall, install a new one, get all the wires into it.
Ms. Green, please do not speak while someone else is speaking. Go ahead, Mr. Harris.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. I installed a new panel. Put the wires in, it attached each of them to each other breaker, and I found some wires that was rolled up inside Ms. Green's ceiling that needed to go in the panel. When I left there, they were all working.
So when she asked you to increase the amperage, what would that have required you to do?
I would have to go back, take that breaker out,
breaker.
And buy a new breaker.
Wait, did you mean panel?
No, the main breaker. That's what is the main breaker.
Okay.
I had to buy a new one, take that one out, and put in apart in that panel. The main breaker is what carried the amperage.
Ms. Green, is the new electrician is someone who's already been paid, right? Do you have an affidavit from them, or can you get them on the phone?
Yeah, right now.
Let's try that.
Because he's lying.
What's that number?
Jose, and he does good work.
Okay, so I'm just going to ask you, please, to not talk.
I'm not.
Hello, Mr. Rumaniak. This is Judge Miliang from the People's Court. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. So, Mr. Rumaniak, talk to me and tell me, when Ms. Green called you to come and look at stuff, what was it she told you was wrong and what she needed you to do?
She hired somebody to do the upgrade of the service from 100 amps to 200 amps.
Right.
But the person that did the job only replaced the panel.
Why did she need 200 amps, do you think?
Because she wanted to put a swimming pool and a hot tub. And the panel that she had was very small. It was a new panel, but was still a 100-amp panel.
Can I ask you a question? Would that 100 amp panel allow the attaching of a swimming pool and jacuzzi?
No.
Mm-mm. No.
Okay.
No.
So that had to be upgraded in order to allow for a swimming pool and jacuzzi?
Yes.
Okay. Mr. Umaña, muchas gracias.
You're welcome.
Adios. The only remaining question is, did you know and did she tell you that she was going to put in a swimming pool and a jacuzzi? And if I look and if I find that, in fact, you knew that she was putting in a swimming pool and a jacuzzi, then you should have darn well known that she was going to need greater amperage. But on top of that, even without the installation of the swimming pool and the jacuzzi, it was already failing. Now, she expects you to be the expert. You knew because in your quote, you say swimming pool and jacuzzi that she's going to be bringing in. So I find that she is entitled to her $1,300 back, and I am ordering you to pay her back her $1,300. That is my verdict. Good luck, folks.
Well, the plaintiff looks really happy. Mr. Harris, I don't think you're so happy. What do you think about the judge's decision? You got to give the money back.
I'm all right. Yeah, I'm all right.
You're okay?
I'm okay.
Do you think you could have done a better job for her?
I've done a better job, but she's just, you know, vindictive. It's okay. It's okay.
All right. No, well, you're a pretty amenable guy. All right, good enough. You lost the case, but you still seem okay. Ms. Green, you seem very happy. You're in a good mood
very
now,
happy,
aren't you?
Very happy. Yes, I'm gonna celebrate. Yes, I'm glad this just seen what it was worth. She's seen what I couldn't really explain, but that's what I wanted. 200 amps with an upgrade with a jacuzzi and pool, and I got it. So thank you so much for letting me on your show. And shout out to Queens, y'all. I'm in the building.
That lady's in a good mood. Really
thank
good
you.
Mood. Harvey, let's get your perspective on this case.
So, Doug, it's a good example of getting everything in writing up front. So when you make a contract with somebody to do work like this, you write down exactly what services are supposed to be performed for the money that you're paying. Write it down as specifically as possible. She did enough that the judge said he didn't do the job, and that's why she got her money.
Who are your favorite male and female actors from movies from before 1970, way back?
Ooh, wow. Jeez. You know, I was a child before 1970,
so. You've only seen historical evidence of it.
Yes, I've seen historical evidence of it, I guess. Okay, so what's like my favorite 60s movie? Oh, probably The Graduate.
Ah.
Yeah, and so the male would be Dustin Hoffman and the female would be Anne Bancroft, who was gorgeous and an amazing actress. I loved her and everything she did post 70 also.
Yeah, she was amazing. In fact, better than Dustin Hoffman in the movie. Okay? But, you know, with all due credit to Dustin Hoffman, you know, a great actor and certainly a great...
And someone who later did Rain Man.
That's right.
And
he's done so many great movies.
Wait, don't move on. And in Rain Man, there is a famous scene where he kept saying, gotta watch a people's court, gotta watch
That's
a people's
right.
court. So
absolutely.
Yep.
So I suppose you're going to ask me now which ones I would
Yes.
pick, right? Okay. I'm going to say for the actor, I'm going to say Lee Marvin, okay? He was in so many movies, and he was usually a tough guy or a bad guy. But then when I was maybe in first grade, he made a movie called Cat Ballou, and he was a funny guy. It was actually comedic, and he ended up winning an Oscar for it. And plus, he was in The Dirty Dozen.
So. And favorite female?
I'm going to say...
Barbara.
One
say Barbara.
Listen, this one's coming way out of right field. Piper Laurie. She played opposite Paul Newman in The Hustler in 1961, and it was just... It was a role that was just... She should have won the Oscar for best actress that year, and she didn't, but she was absolutely phenomenal.